guys, welcome back. I hope you guys are having a beautiful day, and if not, I hope your day gets better. In this video, we are gonna be doing my left hand, and this is for my birthday. So this is my second birthday nail set. It's different. I was gonna do something green, but honestly, I've been wanting a blue nail set, so that's what we're doing today. But I am gonna show you guys how I do my prep, because I do want these nails to last. So I am gonna go ahead and push back the cuticles. Once I'm done with that, I am going to go in with this round drill bit, and I'm just going to go ahead and go around the cuticle area. I usually go in with like one of those flaming drill bits and then go in with like the round drill bit, but since I'm not using the nippers today, I'm just going to go ahead and go in with this little drill bit. Alright, so once that is done, I am gonna go in with my fine grit sanding band, and I am removing like that top sharpness from the sanding band. It's kind of like what I do with the nail file. I do with the sanding band too, because I have cut myself, and I have found when I like do that, like I find it much easier, like I don't cut myself or anything. So yeah, but next I'm just gonna go ahead and work like the sanding band around like the walls and like the side walls, and then also around like the cuticle area, and then I'm also removing the shine off the tips, and then just taking off like the remaining product that I had on from my previous set. I find taking off poly gel kind of complicated. I do, like, I file all the way down, and then, like, I buff all, like, as much as I can. And then I use, like, acetone, but for some reason, I always get, like, some residue. So, yeah, I don't know. I find removing poly gel a little bit tricky. So, if you guys have any tricks, let me know, please, down in the comments below. Alright, so next I'm gonna go ahead and glue on this tips, and I am using McCart's nail glue. I really like it. I've been using it and actually works really well. But once that is done and I have all the nail tips glued on, I am gonna go in with my nail tip cutter, and I am cutting these down to the desired length. I do end up going a little bit shorter than this just because like I wanted to make sure I was able to function and stuff. But yeah, so next I'm gonna remove the shine off the tip, and then also making sure that I blend in where I glued on the tip, that way everything is nice and smooth and even for the application. And then once that is done, I went ahead and I cleaned off the nails. And next I'm gonna go in with Mia Secrets primer and dehydrator. I like using these. I also use Model 1's. Like, I find Model 1's primer and dehydrator really good, but I'm using Mia Secret today. I do go ahead and put dehydrator twice because my hands do get pretty oily, and then I go in with the primer just once. Alright, so now it's time for the nail application. So I'm going to go ahead and do this nail ombre. So I am going in with Macart's La Coral Poly Gel. And I just went ahead and put like a decent bead right there around the cuticle area. And I am going to ombre this out. Instead of doing like the regular ombre, like where, you know, like the where the cuticle area like ombres out, I'm doing it reverse. So where the tip is, it's gonna ombre out with like the glitter. That's just how I wanted it. So yeah, with a drier brush, so like I try to work around that cuticle area with like a drier brush, like not too much alcohol. But when I go ahead and do the ombre, I like have way less like liquid on my brush, and I've noticed when I do that, it helps create the ombre. So this part right here, I was gonna use this poly gel, and this is from Macart too. I really love this poly gel. I think this blue is very beautiful, but it wasn't what I wanted. Like, for one, it wasn't ombreing like I wanted it to. So yeah, I do end up removing this, and I do end up going in with just like regular glitter. I don't know, I felt like it just wasn't giving what I wanted it to give, you know. I'm sure like if I would have worked with it and like ombred it out, it would have looked fine. It's just, I don't know, it wasn't what I was going for. So I do end up like taking this off and starting over, and I did the same thing for my pinky, because like I know you guys could see that my pinky is done, and I end up like taking it down all the way down like as much as I can, and I end up doing like glitter on the top, and then I encapsulate it with some clear, and that's what I did. So this is me here fixing it. So I put a layer of base coat, and I put it just to where I want like the ombre to be at, and I am using this blue glitter, and this is what I wanted. I wanted like chunky loose glitter. So I'm gonna go in with my Madame Glam's brush, and I'm just gonna go ahead and pat this in. I do end up doing my middle finger, and instead of doing this, I just dip it in a certain degree, and then with my ombre brush, I do kind of ombre out. You'll see me do like everything I just said, like I left it on in there, that way you guys could see how like I created the ombre look. But once that is done, I did want to mention that before putting like the clear poly gel, I did a layer of base coat, like a kind of thick layer, because I feel like when I just put the poly, like the clear poly gel over, like it doesn't, I don't know, it just doesn't look well. So I figured like if I put like a kind of like a base of base coat and then put the clear, like it'll work. So I don't know if all that made sense, but I'll let you guys enjoy some of this nail application, and then like always, I'll come in and chit chat with you guys. Thank you. I hope you guys had a good weekend. I had a pretty chill weekend. I'm sorry that I didn't post on Thursday. Honestly, I just needed a little break. But I'm back. This is my nail set. So my birthday was on May 29th. And I know I'm posting these videos like a little late. I'm sorry, but yeah. But yeah, like I said, our weekend was super chill. My son had evaluations like for tackle. So we went to go do that in the morning. And then afterwards, we came home. And then we went to the San Jose Panthers game. It was like a team thing. And like the kids went on the field and played. And it was lots of fun. It was really cool. So yeah, and then on Sunday, it was just a very chill day, you know, like, just relaxed and all that, because the craziness is about to start with football and tackle and all this stuff, so I've just been chilling before the craziness starts again, so yeah, that was my weekend. It was pretty chill. Also, I may not be posting on Thursday. I am going on vacation to San Diego. I'm going to go see my family out there, and then my cousin's baby shower and all that stuff. So I may not post on Thursday. I do want to let you guys know now, but I don't know. I might not. We'll see. But, yeah, I'll let you guys enjoy more of this PolyGel application, and I'll come in and chit chat with you guys some more. So next, I'm going to go ahead and go in with my fine grit sanding band, 100-180 grit nail file, my Makart dust collector, and I'm going to start filing and shaping these nails. We'll be right back. So now it's time for the nail art. And the nail art for this is going to be super easy. My middle finger is going to have like a row of like these rhinestones. And then my index finger and my ring finger are just going to be top coated. And then my pinky is going to have like this Gemini charm. And that's basically it for like the nail art. I have been wanting to do like some rhinestone nail art, and I figured why not for my birthday set. So yeah. Honestly, I had no idea what I wanted to do. Like, I've been wanting like a rhinestone nail set. Like, I feel, yes, I've been using like the pearls and stuff, but I haven't really been using rhinestones like I used to, and I kind of miss it. And I wanted to do like a rhinestone nail set, and I figured why not something like this. It's cute, it's simple. Honestly, I loved it. I usually do like way more to my nails for my birthday, but I don't know. I figured this was still cute. I already went all out on my right hand, so yeah. Also, I wanted to say thank you to everyone who's been subscribing. I've been seeing, and honestly, like, it just, you guys are awesome. Like, I really, really love you guys. And, like, I don't know, I've been getting super excited every time I see, like, a new subscriber, a new comment or something. Oh my god, like, I just always scream, and I'm like, oh my god, Anthony! Like, ah! Like, I don't know, I just get super, super happy. So, yes. Thank you so much. And also, about the little giveaway that I've been thinking about. So I am going to do it. But I think this giveaway, I am going to do it like from my Instagram. So if you guys are following me on my Instagram, I might post it there. I don't know. Or I might just keep it on YouTube. I don't know. This is how the nails came out. And like I said, I don't know, I think these are super cute. I've been wanting a set like this. I've been doing like kind of like a lot of nail art, I don't know, but I've been wanting just a blue set and like with rhinestones and whatnot. So yeah, this is officially my second birthday nail set. I usually do a lot of nail sets before my birthday, but I don't know, this year I've been so busy. It was very hectic, and yeah, I didn't get a chance to do a bunch, but like always, this is how they look outside, and I just think these are super, super cute, and yeah, but I hope you guys enjoyed. Like always, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll be seeing you guys soon. Bye.